G'day everyone. Welcome to a bit of a midweek update, I suppose. Sort of, more along the lines of a bit of an announcement. A couple of people have already figured it out in the comments. But very, very soon, within the next few weeks, I'm actually just waiting for a weather window to open up. Kiarra and I, and Dad, are going to take a trip. Now, I don't have my computer in front of me, a bit sort of ill-prepared, otherwise I'd sort of give you a bit more of a visual representation. But we're going to go from Lake Macquarie here to Port Stephens. Now, that probably doesn't mean much to a lot of people. Some people it probably does. It's a journey of about 70 nautical miles from mooring to mooring. Now, I say that because I am moving moorings. Lake Macquarie is... it's a bit over an hour for me to travel each way to the boat, and I'm just struggling to get any real work done. That also might help explain why you're not seeing a lot of big structural work being done to the boat. It's more, you know, engine work and hull cleaning and maintenance. All that is in preparation for what more than likely will be a 10 to 14 hour run, depending on weather and, you know, whether I strike any issues. The journey itself is pretty straightforward. The seas aren't overly treacherous or anything like that. We'll never be more than sort of, I would say, probably 4 or 5 nautical miles offshore at any one point. There's two sections where things are a little bit trickier. To get out of Lake Macquarie where we are, we've got to go through a channel. Now that channel is called Swansea Channel. And we've got to go under Swansea Bridge. Swansea Bridge lifts up, you book it in, you go under the bridge, not the end of the world. The channel, however, is quite narrow, and you do have to pick your tides. If you're trying to exit the channel on a run-out tide, it can be quite dangerous. It rips through there, and especially in a boat like this that's a bit underpowered, it can tend to throw you around the channel as you go down if you're going with the tide. That's the first sort of major navigational thing, and I'll hit that probably an hour from my current mooring location. Then realistically I've got probably about 3 hours worth of constant running, and I will hit Newcastle Harbour. I may or may not go into Newcastle Harbour. It really depends on how the boat's going, how the weather's going, and really how I'm running as far as fuel burn and, you know, everything like that. But Newcastle Harbour is a really good safe port, and it's a really good safe haven. Once I go straight past Newcastle, if I choose to, I have probably about a, what do we got? I think it's about another five hours till I hit Port Stephens headlands. So we got Tomaree on one side and Yakabar on the other. Those heads, while fairly wide, there is two big sandbars that sort of run into the heads or across the heads. Port Stephens can have a bit of a reputation. If you hit the wrong tide and the wrong winds, it gets real big real quick. Again, waiting for a weather window, and we'll see how we go. So I guess some of the major concerns are, you know, mechanical. As you've seen in most of the videos, I've been basically trying to fix the engine to a point where I'm satisfied that it will fire up and run for 10 to 14 hours and not give me any dramas. I've still got a few things. I've still got one particular radiator hose I'm going to change. Cooling hose, not radiator hose. And everything else seems pretty good. I do have a spare belt on board now. I've got spare fuel filters, I'm going to bring spare spark plugs, I'm going to change the plugs and I'll keep the other ones for spares. That sort of stuff's going to stay on board, and I'll be bringing other bits and pieces as well, like spare cooling hoses, hose clamps, all that sort of stuff. I mean, the other concern would be the boat itself. Okay. The boat itself, I'm going to say, is probably not designed for open ocean running. But that's not really what we're doing. We're going offshore. But we're not going open ocean, and that stretch of water that I'm talking about. I think what I will try and do, hopefully in the background or maybe up in a corner, we'll see how I go, is I'll put a map up and draw a line of where it is we're going to run. Like I said, it's not a particularly bad stretch of water. It can whip up, but if we pick our days, pick our weather, then we'll be okay. So that's about all I got. I just wanted to throw it up as a real quick midweek one. I'm again, thank you to anybody who's watched, subscribed, commented. I'm overwhelmed by the comments. I mean, by and large, they're all very positive and very helpful. I'm trying to take on board as much information as I can from them. Obviously, some of you are very knowledgeable and far more knowledgeable than me. And I'm trying to take on board everything I can. So I think we'll leave it there. Yeah, as I said, that'll be coming up very soon. Hopefully this weekend we'll get a prop change done. And once I'm done that, that's basically all I can do with what I have to make the boat go as well as it can with what I've got. And then we'll see how we go. I'm going to film the journey. I'll film every bit. I'll probably break it up into two videos because it'll be quite long. But yeah, stay tuned for that. And thank you all again. And we'll catch you on the next one, which should be the prop change video.